Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Welcome to our second PU Computer Science online classes. So in this class we are going to cover the concept of input and output operations on binary files. Second, dictating the end of file. Third one, file pointers and their manipulations. Fourth one, basic operation on binary file in C++. Thank you.
Hello, good morning student. Welcome to everyone. Now in our next point, why? Because we already completed some information from our data file handling, and you know that how many classes are there about our if stream, off stream, and also the f stream here, and also we know that which header file going to use in our file input and output operation, and also know some of the important types of the data files like text file, binary file, and about the opening and closing files here, and some information about the opening and closing, and as well as some of the concept of file modes. Important file modes are in, out, and app mode in this case. Now in today's class, or in this class, we are going to complete some other important topic about our data file handling, that is the input and output operation on binary files. The input and output operation on binary files here. So before going to start, any information or what are the functions going to use, or the member function going to use in our binary files here, just I want to recall our last class, whatever the member function we use in our text file. We know that in our text file, these some important member functions are going to use put member function, get member function, and also the get line member function. And we know the uses of to input single character, to display the single character, as well as the get line is using to input a group of character, and such character to input a group of characters. Okay, no? Okay. Now after completing each and everything from the text file, now let's, in today's class I selected the point, that is the input and output operation on binary files. We know the meaning of the binary file. So it is a file that contains, that means whatever the information we are going to store, such information are going to held what in the same manner, that is held in the memory. Clear this point here? So it is a file that contains the information in the same format as it is held in the memory. There is no any translation and no delimiter character are going to use. The delimiter character is called as the EOL, the full form of the EOL, end of line. So when you are going to write EOL character, some translation occur here, correct? No? So that means if any translation occur here, that means it called as the text file. It is not called as the binary file. When it is called as the binary file, we know that in our binary file we are not going to use any delimiter character or the EOL character. So no any delimiter character, that means no any translation occurring here. Okay. Now later, next thing, well, because we know the meaning of the binary file, now some of the function, member function, or very important, most important member function going to use in binary files are write member function and the read member function. So before going to tell the write member function, now let's some information about the read member function. Why? Because before going to display any information, let's first of all we are going to input some information into the file, or some information we are going to collect from the file here. Okay, now our first member function, we know that I already said, we already know there are two member functions are there, write member function and the read member function. So first of all I want to select the read member function. So here we can say that The read member function belong to the class if stream. I want to import the data. So that means inputting data, the class name is the if stream. Okay, the read member function belongs to the class if stream. And what's the use of the read member function? So this member function or the read member function is used to input, that is called as the read, binary data from a file. That means here maybe we know that some information before going to take, before going to do any inputting and outputting operation, first of all I am going to add, or first of all we are going to add some information into the file. And maybe you want to do some of the operation, maybe the input operation or whatever kind of the output operation, anything, what's the operation you want to perform, everything we are going to collect from the file, and laterwards we are doing some of the operation. So the read member function, we know that belong to which class. Now this function is used to read, that is called as the input, binary data from a file. Okay, kya? Now syntax. Now what's the syntax of the read member function? So the syntax is the if stream underscore object dot read, then opening of the parentheses, char pointer, closing of the parentheses, ampersand variable, comma, size of opening of the parentheses variable, then closing of the parentheses twicely, semicolon. Now this is the syntax of the read member function, and we know that why we using the read member function. Okay, now after that, just only I want to explain about the syntax here, whatever we written by using our syntax. And in this case, first of all, if stream underscore object. So such if stream underscore object is an object of type if stream. That means how we are going to use. So the if stream underscore object is the object of type if stream is sure we are going to use the fin. Clear this point? When you are going to view the example, the third line or maybe the second line. So laterwards I will explain about this one. Now just only the if stream underscore object, how I completed in example, if you are going to think about this one or see this third line, that means I used as the fin. Clear this point here? So the if stream underscore object, that is the fin here, dot read, then char pointer, ampersand variable, and size of the variable. And this function, read member function, requires two arguments. Clear this point here? We need to, when you are going to complete or when you are going to use such a syntax, we need to use two arguments, or it requires the two arguments here. The first argument is the address of the variable. So which one is called as the address? So wherever I written ampersand variable, clear this point here, ampersand variable. So this is called as the address of the variable, which data you want to input from the file. Okay, yeah, from the file here, first of all we need to think about the address of the variable before going to collect any data from the memory space variable. Okay, kya? So ampersand variable is the first argument, and it is the address of the variable, kya? Or in other words, we can say that the contents of which are read from the file. Clear this point here? So whatever we are going to read, that means inputting from the file, in this case here we know such address of the variable kya. And the second argument is called as the size of the variable. That means how many size of the variable. Maybe you are going to take the book. The book means the size of the book is the 0 to 3, that is equal to 4. So like that only whatever the variable you are going to input from the file here, we need the size of the variable of such file in this case here. So clear this point here? And later next one, just only I completed. So ampersand variable, before that I written as the char pointer. So what's the meaning of this one? So again I am repeating, ampersand variable, I already explained what's the meaning of the ampersand variable, that is called as the address of the variable and the size of the variable. Clear this point here? This function required two arguments. Now I am going to tell about the char pointer in this case here. So the address of the variable, ampersand variable, that is I am going to tell, the address of the variable is just type converted to the pointer char. Why we are going to convert such our ampersand variable into the pointer char in this case here? So clear this point here. Now just I am going to convert the ampersand variable into the pointer variable char pointer variable or to pointer to char type here, because the function read member function not bothering about, or we can say that does not bother to know the type of the variable. Clear this point. It don't want which type of variable we are going to input in this case here. So clear this point. Just only because of this reason, whatever is there in address of the variable, we are going to convert into the char pointer. Clear this point, to the char type here. Just we know that what's the meaning of this one. Why we are going to convert? Because the read function does not bother about to know which type of variable we are going to input from one to another here. Which type of variable we are going to input here? It just want to require the data in terms of bytes only, 010101, like that here. So clear this point here. Now let's the example. So in this example, the student has semicolon. Second one is the if stream, fin, opening of the parenthesis, opening of the double quotation, std.dat, closing of the double quotation, comma, and later next one, iOS binary. We know that in this case, the meaning of the second line, we open the binary file and the file name is the std.dat for the input purposes only. Clear this part, the second line about the first line, I am just declare one object. The name of the object is the S in this case here. The name of the object, that is the S in S, some of the information it's there. Clear this point here. So now the second line going to tell about here, we open the binary file and the last line fin dot read, then char pointer, closing of the parenthesis, ampersand s comma size of s. So here we can say that we are going to input a student record from the file. Clear this point here. We are inputting or reading a student record from the file. The file name is the std.dat into the object s. That means we are going to convert any inputted data. We are going to convert the data that is from std file into the object s. Clear this point. We inputted the data from one to another. So this is so read member function going to use. Why? Because the meaning is we just going to input the data into the file. That means we collected the data from the file and one in one place we are going to input such data. The place name is the S in this case here. So clear this point. The read member function, what's the use of the read member function? So we can say that in simple meaning, I want to tell about the read member function. The read member function belong to class if stream and which is used to input the binary data from the file. Clear this point here. In one file, some of the information is there. So we are going to collect the information from the file and we are going to input into one place, to the place the name is, or the object, into the object. The object name is the S here. And we know that about the ampersand variable as well as the size of the variable. Now, after completing the read member function, now let's some information about our write member function. Okay, so we know that what's the use of the read member function. That means we are going to input data, so such member function going to use. So whatever the data we inputted, now I want to display such a data. So how we are going to display such a data? We know that by using the member function. The member function is the write member function. Okay, here, so we can say that the write member function belong to the class of stream. Clear this point here. It is very important thing. Well, because here it is very important question also, what's the difference between read and write? So one difference only we can say here. The first difference, we read member function belong to the class if stream, but the write member function belong to the class of stream here. Now let's what's the use of the write member function. So the write member function is used to write. The meaning of the write, display. Okay, here, so which is used to display binary data to a file. Whatever the information we read from the file, such one going to write, such one going to display by using the member function, write member function. So clear this point here. Okay, now syntax. The syntax is the offstream underscore object dot write, opening of the parenthesis twicely, char pointer, closing of the parenthesis, ampersand variable, comma, size of, opening of the parenthesis, variable, and then closing of the parenthesis twicely, semicolon. Now this is the syntax of the write member function. And we know that, well, because I already explained in our read member function the meaning of the ampersand variable as well as the size of the variable. Now let's, whatever about our write member function, whether the meaning is going to change or as it is about the ampersand variable. So here we can say that there is no any changes in the meaning. So whatever I said in our read member function, the same thing going to apply in our write. Just only the difference between read and write, the read is using to input data from the file here, but write is using, that means to display binary data to a file. So here also, our offstream underscore object. So in this case, offstream underscore object, or the object of the type offstream, that is the fout. Clear this point here. So we are not going to use in syntax or in example directly the offstream underscore object. Maybe in first syntax, maybe we are going to write, but laterwards we are going to change such one to the our fout only. So in this case, we can say that offstream underscore object, that is fout, is an object of type offstream. And here also, the write member function requires two arguments. Okay, the write member function requires two arguments, and we know that the arguments are, the first one is the ampersand variable, and second one is the size of the variable. And we know the meaning of ampersand variable as well as the size of the variable. But also I want to tell here, the first argument, that is the address of the variable. The address of the variable means the content of which are written to the file. Clear this point. Here, that means here we can say that first of all we need which file you want to display. First of all we need the address of such variable file. Clear this point here. That means we know that in the file some of the content are there which are going to display to the file here. And the second one is the call as the size of the variable. Clear this point here. The second one, that is the size of the variable here. And we know that about the ampersand variable, before that the char pointer is there. Correct this point here. Before that the char pointer is there. What's the meaning of this one? That means the address of the variable is just converted to the pointer to char type. Clear this point. So here we are going to write, before the ampersand variable we using the char pointer. The meaning is just only whatever is there in address of the variable, such one going to convert to the pointer to char type, because the write function does not bother to know the type of the variable. They don't want which type of variable we are going to input here. Any type of variable we can import, just only, so just because of the char pointer. Why? Because such one go using just to convert to the pointer to the char type. So meaning is we can input any type of the variable. There is no any problem in this case. And whatever the data going to accept, just accepting, going to accept only in the byte format. Clear this point here. We know the meaning of the byte. The byte is the that means here the basic storage or the accessible unit in memory. That means whatever we are going to store, that such one going to accessible. Clear in this case here. Now after that, after knowing the each and every information about our syntax or the meaning of the write member function, now let's one example. So in this example, the student S, and second one is the offstream fout, and opening of the parenthesis std.dat, closing of the parenthesis, comma, ios binary. So first one, just only to declare, to take one object, the name of the object is the s here. And second line, going to explain about we open the file, the binary file. It is not the text or any type of file. We open the binary file here. The file name is the std.dat for the output purposes. Clear this point here. And later next one is the fout.write. Opening of the parenthesis twicely. Care pointer, closing of the parenthesis, ampersand s comma size of s. The meaning is the display the content of the object s to the file std.dat. So whatever the object is there in our s, we already inputted by using the read member function. Correct? Now here we know the meaning of the read member function. What's the use of the read member function? The read member function is used to read binary data from a file. So whatever we inputted, such one going to display. So such information we can display by using the member function. The member function name is called as the write member function. Clear this point? So totally we can say the example meaning as the write, that is called as the display the content of the object as to the file std.dat. Clear this point here? Okay, now after knowing the read and write member function, also by using example each and everything here, now let's next thing about our dictating the end of file. Now what's the meaning of the dictating the end of file in this case here? So we can say that maybe sometime we are going to input the data continuously, so it's not possible. That means we need to stop. So here just only to check whether we need to stop or whatever is there here. So just we using one file. The name of the file is the end of file. Now let's, what's the use of the dictating the end of file? So while reading, that is called as inputting the contents of a file, the care has to be taken. That means when you are going to input some data into the file, first of all we need to take some of the care. And what's the care we need to take? To see that the operation does not cross the end of file. That means whatever the operation, and the our operation is we are going to input some data into the file, so this is our operation. That means what's the operation we are going to perform? Such operation does not cross the end of the file. Clear this point here? So just only to check, we using the member function. So which member function going to use? So the member function is the iOS class provides member function. The name of the member function is called as the EOF member function. Clear this point? Maybe I want to check, that means whether we need to stop the end of the file, whether we need to stop the operation, where that means we are going to input some data into the file, whether we need to stop or we need to add some data. So whatever we can check by using the member function. That means by using the member function, the name of the member function is the EOF. Clear this point here? And such member function helps in dictating the end of file. You know the meaning of the end of file. Clear this point here? So that means while reading, the content of the file here is called as the end of file in this case here. So once the end of file is dictated with the use of EOF member function, we can stop reading further. Correct? Now in this case here, when you are going to reach to the end of the file here, we need to stop. Why? Because when you are going to input some data into the file, there is no use in this case. So till where the memory space is there, till there we can input the data, but after that whatever the data you are going to input, there is no use in this case. So just only to check whether the data is, whether the memory is full, or whether we inputted whatever the data is there, whether it's enough, just we are going to check by using the member function. The member function is called as the end of file in this case. And such end of file, that means our belong to the class iOS. So the iOS class provides member function. The member function is the EOF member function here. And here some of the important note are that about the 1 and 0 value. So EOF member function returns true value. True value, that is equal to non-zero. Non-zero value is called as the 1. So when it going to display the value 1 or the display the value true value, if end of file is encountered. That means if the end of file is reached. Clear this point here. If the end of file is reached on that time, it going to display the value. The value is the one here. And while reading, so otherwise, which value it going to display? It going to display the return value. The return value is the false. That is the zero. Clear this point here. Yeah, we can say that when it going to reach to the end of the file, then it going to display the value 1 here while reading, while inputting the data here. Otherwise, return the value false. That means we can add some other data into the file also here. Now, let's some of the syntax in this case, or we can say that one simple example or like our coding. So, if opening of the parentheses fin dot eof and closing of the member function, closing of the parentheses, and by using opening and closing of the flower bracket, we used some of the statements. So why we using such syntax? The meaning of the syntax in this case, we can say about this one here. About this one here, this is used to execute the set statement on reaching the end of file. Clear this point here. So when it going to reach to the end of the file, that is represented by the object fin in this case here. So clear this point. So why we using such syntax here? Whenever this is such or such syntax specially used to execute the set of the statement. So execute the set of the statement on reaching the end of the file. Clear this point here. So the end of the file in this case here. Now after knowing, and maybe some other syntax is there in this case here. So the syntax is the while opening of the parentheses not fin dot eof and closing of the parentheses, then again opening of the flower bracket statements, closing of the flower bracket here. So this syntax is using why? Because to execute the set of the statement as long as the end of file fin is not reached. When if it is reached, then we need to use our syntax. The syntax is the fin dot eof, but when it is not going to reach on that time, we need to use our not fin of end of file. Clear this point here? Okay, now after knowing the meaning of dictating the end of file in this case, and we know that what's the meaning of dictating the end of file. That means here we are going to think about whether we need to stop while going to input any data into the file, or we need to add some data into the file by using the member function eof member function. And after that, after completing the dictating the end of file, the next thing about our file pointers and their manipulation. The file pointers and their manipulation in this case here. So in case of the file pointers, that means it going to work like our cursor. So how, well, while going to enter some data into the file, how we are going to add the cursor? So from where you are going to adding the cursor, from that only the whatever the inputting is there going to start. So like that only in our data file handling, we using some of the file pointers. So now we are going to discuss about the file pointers and their manipulation. So in C++, the file input output operations are completed with two file pointers. We are going to associate it, or such input output operations are associated with two file pointers. The name of the file pointers known as get pointer and the put pointer. So clear this point here. So why we using? Why? Because maybe if you want to add some data into the file, and that means by using the get pointer, we are going to put the cursor. We are going to use the cursor here. And so here we can say that in our C++, the file input output operations are associated with two file pointers known as get pointer and the put pointer. So such get pointer are specially used for input pointer, and the put pointer is used for the output pointer respectively. Clear this point here? That means whatever the data we are going to input by using our get pointer, and maybe you want to display where the cursor is there. If you want to display by using the pointer like our put pointer here, we can use. So they are useful In this case here, they are useful in visiting the opened file while reading or the writing. Now let's some information about our get pointer and the put pointer. What's the use? So IfStream class, that is called as the IStream. Okay, the IfStream class called as the IStream contain a pointer or has a pointer, and such pointer known as the get pointer. And we know that the meaning of IfStream, to input data, and we using the pointer. The pointer name is called as the get pointer. And now what's the use of the get pointer? That points to the element, okay, that points to the element to be input in the next input operation. Maybe you want to input some data into the file here. First of all, we need to place the cursor properly. So just only such our get pointer going to perform the work like that only. Clear this point here? So we can say that our IfStream, like IStream, has a pointer, and such pointer name as the get pointer. Now the uses of the get pointer is using to point to the element. That means where you want to input some data into the file here, just it going to place the cursor there. Clear this point here? So points to the element to be input in the next input operation. And like that only the put pointer. Now the use of the put pointer. So offstream, like OStream. Clear this point? The offstream like OStream also contain a pointer or has a pointer known as the put pointer. Now what's the use of the put pointer? That means the put pointer is using points to the location where the next element has to be written. That means which element you want to display. Clear this point? From which element you want to display the data, we are going to point from this point here. So this is the use of the put pointer. So clear this point here, the meaning of the get pointer and the put pointer. So in simple words, we can say that how we are going to place the cursor and from where you are going to place the cursor. Like that only we are going to input some data into the file here. So like that our get pointer and the put pointer going to work. Okay, so again I am repeating the meaning of the get pointer. So the get pointer points to the element to be input. Okay, from which place you want to input the data, it going to place the cursor from this point here. And put pointer is using that points to the location where the next element has to be written. That means from which point you want to display the data here. So this is the work. This is the work of the get pointer and the put pointer here. And after completing the get and the put pointer, I want to tell some of the opening a file about the mode. So before going to tell anything information about opening a file and about any kind of the mode, when the input and output operation is performed, the appropriate pointer is automatically advanced. That means maybe you want to input any data, the get pointer going to come to the file here, or maybe you want to display any data, the put pointer going to join with the file. Clear this point? So we can say that in case you want to input and output operation, so whatever is there, when you want to input and output operation, when you want to perform, the appropriate pointer is automatically advanced. Clear this point here? Now there are three modes under which we can open a file. There are three type of modes are there under which we can open a file in this case here. So the first one is the read only mode, second one is the write only mode, and third one is the append mode. Clear this point? Now I am going to explain about read only mode. So when a file open in a read only mode, you are going to open the file in read only mode. That means I want to import some data into the file, that is called as the read only mode. That means the get pointer is automatically set to the very first byte. Correct? Now when you are going to start any information to input into the file, then sure there is no doubt we are going to add the cursor to the very first byte of the file here. So clear this point? The very first byte, that is called as the zeroth byte in this case here. So we can say that when file is open in read only mode, that means you are going to input some data into the file. Our first point is the get pointer. Cursor should point to the or set to the very first byte, that is equal to 0th byte of the file. Similarly, when file is open in write only mode, that means I want to display some information, whatever we return by using read only mode, such information I want to display, that is called as the write only mode. So here I opened the file for write only mode. That means here we can say that the put pointer is set to the first byte of the file. Correct? Now, in case you want to display any data, then sure you need to put the cursor, you need to place the cursor, that is from the first byte of the file only, the first byte of the file only here, so that we can write the data from the beginning. That means we can display the data from the beginning in this case here. So clear this point. What about I said here? So first of all, you want to input some data into the file. That means we are going to place the cursor from the 0th byte, that is by using the get pointer. And maybe whatever the data is there in a file you want to display, that is called as the write only mode. That means first of all we need to set the put pointer from the 0th byte so that we can display data from the beginning. But in some situation, that means I want to add some more data into the file, we know that by using the file mode, the file mode is the append mode. So just only I want to tell about the append mode. So in some situation, it would be necessary for us to add new data to the existing file. We already created the file and we already added some data into the file, but later words I am thinking, or we need to think about, we need to add some more data into the file here. So we can say that it would be necessary for us to add new data to the existing file. So in this case we have to open the file in append mode. Clear this point here. We have to open the file. In this case, we have to open the file in the append mode in this case here. So here we can say that when file is open in a append mode, the put pointer moves to the end of the file. That means we already completed some information by using get pointer. We already know what are the informations are there by using write only mode here. Now I want to add some more data into the file here. So I am going to place the put pointer cursor to the end of the file, and after placing, then only I can write some information by using get pointer. Correct? Now in this case, so that we write new data from that location by using the get pointer. So clear this point here. And whatever we completed, the data we return by using the get pointer, such data we can display, write the new data from that location. So clear this point here. So here we can say that there are three modes are there. That means to open a file, first one is the read only mode, second one is the write only mode, and third one is the append mode. And we know that read only mode, that means to input data by using the get pointer, and later next one I want to display, that means whatever the data we inputted, I want to know what's the data is there, I want to display on monitor here. That means by using the put pointer, that is called as the write only mode. And later words you are thinking, I want to add some more information into the file here. That means we can add some information into the file by using the mode like our append mode in this case here. So in case of the append mode, we can say that when you are adding some data into the append mode, first of all we need to use the get pointer. Correct? No, here first of all, that means here whatever, before going to take the get pointer, first of all we need to use the put pointer move to the end of the file. And by using the get pointer, we are going to add some information into the file, and later words whatever the information we return here, extra information, that is we can display the new data from that location. Now after completing some of the information about our get pointer and the put pointer by using the classes, and also the three important modes by using or opening a file, now some important internal stream pointers. So this is specially going to use the internal inner part in the inner of the files in this case here. So internal stream pointers in this case. So that point to the reading or writing from which place you want to input data, from which place you want to display the data, everything going to happen by using our internal stream pointers here. So we can say that a stream can be calculated using the following member function, or some of the internal stream pointers are: first one is the seekg, second one is the seekp, third one is the tellg, and fourth one is the tellp. Clear this point here? And all are the internal stream pointers. So the first one is the seekg, second one is the seekp, third one is the tellg, fourth one is the tellp. Now let's one by one the work of the member function, internal stream member function. So the first one is the seekg. Okay, g means get pointer, that means it's going to input data into the file. So here we can say that move the get pointer to a specified location from the beginning of a file. Maybe I want to enter some data into the file, then sure I'm using the cursor from the beginning of the file only. Correct no kya? Now there are two types are there. Clear this point here? In this way there are two types are there. The first one is the seekg long, and second one is the seekg offset and seekdir in this case here. So now the meaning of the seekg long, I think about the seekg information is clear to everyone. What's the use of this one? So we can say that here this one is using to add some data into the file here, and we are going to move. So maybe if you are going to open the new file, then sure from the beginning side only we are going to input the data into the file in this case here. And the seekg have two types. First one is the seekg long, second one is the seekg offset and seekdir. The first example, the first meaning, the seekg long moves the get pointer to a specified location from the beginning of a file. Example, in file seekg 20, meaning the above example tells that the get pointer points to the 20th byte. That means it started from the 0th byte and going to reach till 20th byte. Clear this point here? So we can say that here no any. So directly, and always should remember it, maybe in case you want to change the value to instead of 20 to 30, that means it going to start from the 0 to 30th byte. Clear this point here? 0 to the 30th byte. And always remember it, we are placing the cursor from the 0th byte, but we are not going to write any information from the 0th byte here. The next time the cursor going to start any information or any letter, that is from the first position only here. So clear this point here? So we can say that the seekg long moves the get pointer to a specified location, that is from the beginning of a file here. So in this example we can say that our reaching point, that is to the 20th byte, and it going to start from the first byte to the our 20th byte in this case here. Now after the seekg, the next information about our seekg offset and seekdir in this case here. Well, because we know that there are two types are there. First one is the seekg long. We already completed about the information about the seekg long here. But now let's see the next thing about our seekg offset and seekdir. So in case of seekg, offset and seekdir has two arguments. The arguments are, one is the offset and seekdir. Now I'm selecting the second type. The second type is the seekg offset and seekdir. So the two arguments, it contains the two arguments offset and seekdir. So now the meaning of the offset. The offset indicates the number of bytes the get pointer is to be moved from seekdir position. Maybe I'm going to tell now, maybe little bit confusion to you. So you can't understand the meaning of the, I just here if I am going to tell, the offset indicates the number of bytes the get pointer is to be moved from seek dir position. So here we can say that means our offset indicate the number of points till where it going to move. That means from beginning to the 20th byte or from beginning to our 30th byte. So like that it going to use. Clear this point here? The offset means the number of bytes till where it going to move. The get pointer is to be moved from seek dir position. And in our seek dir position, some of the positions are beginning, current and end. That means maybe it started from the beginning to 20th, maybe it started from the current to 20th, or maybe it started from our end to in our backward direction. Clear this point here? So now here we can say that the offset takes long data type, and I already explained about this one, the seek T direction using the following three seek direction constant. So the three constant are IOS beginning. IOS beginning means from the beginning of the file. IOS CUR, that is called as the current, specified from the current position of the get pointer. That means maybe the position of the get pointer in fourth position, this is the current position. Maybe it is there in our sixth position, maybe the cursor going to blink, the get pointer going to blink in sixth position. That means the sixth one is the current position. Clear this point here? From which position they want to move here? So IOS current. And IOS end means specified from the end of the file. Clear this point here? So we can say that, why? Because the first example, no any problem. It going to start from the seek G long, just only going to start. The seek G long just only going to start from 0 to the 20th byte in this case. There is no any problem here. But when you are going to think about our second type, that is the seek G offset. So in this case, till where it going to reach? Correct? No? The offset means number of bytes the get pointer is to be moved from seek dir position. And in our seek dir position, there are three types of the positions are there. First one is the beginning, second one is the current, third one is the end. Clear this point here? Okay. Now let's one example. So the first example, in file seek G 0 IOS beginning. Now it is the example of our second type, that is the seek G offset seek dir. So in this case, seek G as it is, but 0, that is we return in the syntax as the offset. That means I want to reach from beginning to the 0th byte. Clear this point here? From it started from beginning to the 0th byte. So move the get pointer to the 0th byte and started from the beginning of the file here. That means just only first starting only. Now let's the second one. In our second one, seek G 20 IOS current. So move the get pointer to the 20th byte. Clear this point here? Maybe the current position is that in second position, from second to the 20th. That means the next till where we can write the information till 22. Clear this point here? Maybe the cursor is there in second position and you already added the offset as 20. That means it going to move the number of bytes the get pointer is to be moved from seek dir position. So it going to reach to the 22 byte in this case here in the forward direction. Clear this point? Okay, now after the current year, so clear note to everyone, what about the current position? That means wherever the cursor going to blink, it going to start from this position is called as the current position till the 20th byte in this case. That means maybe the position value is 2, so it going to add the value till 20th byte, that is equal to, lastly we will get the current position after completing, that is the 22 byte. Okay, now later the third example, in file seek G minus 20 IOS end. So the above example tells that the get pointer points to the 20th byte. That means here just only we placed the cursor. So SIGGI is using just only to place the cursor. Till here we can't display the information wherever the cursor is there. Everything we can display by using SIGP only. But now just only we using the SIGGI to place the cursor, to place the get pointer cursor. Clear this point? So now the third example, SIGGI minus 20 IOS end. So the above example tells that the get pointer points to the 20th byte in a file from end of the file in backward direction. Okay, now maybe whatever the example is that, maybe by using one simple example, I want to tell the meaning of about all beginning, current and end. So in this example, maybe I want to use some of the letters. So I started from the zeroth position. Maybe we are going to start it from the zeroth position, but we know that whatever the letter going to start from the first position only. So in first position, I used the letter A. In second position, B. Third, C. In fourth position, D. Fifth position, E. Sixth, F. Seventh position, G. Eighth position, H. Ninth position, I. And 10th position, J. 11th position, K. 12, in 12th position L, and in 13th position M, and in last 14th position N. That means I return some of the letters and I started from first position to the 14th position. Our first position letter is the A and the last 14th position letter is the N. Okay. Now after completing, I am using some of the syntax. Why? Because very clearly, very easily I want to tell this example. So first of all, I am using the syntax. So in file SIGG, opening of the parenthesis. So in example, we return 0, but here I want to use 4 IOS beginning. That means I want to start from beginning to the position 4. Clear this point here? The number of bytes, the offset to be moved. The number of bytes, the offset to be moved. So I want to start from the beginning till the position 4. So in our fourth position, which letter is that? That means the letter is the D. Clear this point here? Now the cursor going to blink there. Clear? In this case, now our cursor is there in our fourth position. Now the second example. In file, SIGG, opening of the parenthesis, minus 3, comma, IOS, current, closing of the parenthesis, semicolon. Now in last point, we know that the cursor is going to blink in the position 4. The cursor is blinking in the position 4 in this case here. Now I return the offset value, that is the minus 3. Okay, the offset value is the minus 3. So we need to move in a backward direction. Clear this point here? Our current position is the 4 here. When you are going to move in a backward direction, so we need to move from the D, C, B. Clear this point? I moved from the backward direction. So it going to move from the D, C, B. Now our current position cursor is the B. Clear this point here? The current position cursor is the B here. And lastly, in file SIGG, that is this next example, in file SIGG, opening of the parenthesis, minus 5, comma, IOS end. That means the end means I need to place the cursor in the end of the file, the end line, that is our 14th position. Correct? Now the beginning is the first position, but the end is the 14th position. In 14th position we already return the letter is the N in this case here. So we need to place the cursor there here, and later words we need to move from the end position till the minus 5. So that means when you are going to move from the end position till position minus 5 in backward direction, means we need to move from the N, M, L, K, J. Now our current position going to display in the 10th position. Clear this point here? The position going to display in our 10th position in this case here, or maybe we can say about our 9th position in this case. So clear? About our beginning, current and the end in this case here. So after completing our SIGG long and the SIGG offset and the SIGG here, the next thing about our SIGP. So here I don't want to tell more information, because whatever we inputted by using this seek G, so such one going to display by using our seek P. Okay, wherever the cursor going to blink, if you want to know about this one by using our P, the P that is called as the put pointer, and we know the meaning of the put pointer. So such one going to display the information. Display the information means it depend on the cursor. So wherever the cursor is there, it going to display the information from that point. Okay. Now seek P. So move the put pointer to a specified location from the beginning of a file. I want to display the information from the beginning. So we need to point the put pointer from the specified location. And here also there are two types are there. Seek P long, seek P offset and seek dir. And we know that what's the meaning of the seek P. So whatever we inputted by using seek G, okay, such one going to display. So the seek P long moves the put pointer to a specified location from the beginning of a file. That means whatever I inputted by using seek G, now such information I want to display. So by using the example in file seek B 20, so we can say that the it going to, or it tells that, or this example tells that the put pointer points to the 20th byte in a file from the 0th byte. It going to display the information that is from 0th to the 20th byte here. So this is called about our seek P long. Clear this part? Okay. Now after that, why? Because the next example in this case here, and whatever the information we used by using seek G, such information going to display. So wherever the cursor is there, we need to know. That means by using our seek P, we can understand, we can know wherever the cursor is there. So in this case, here also we know that two types are there. One is the seek P long. We already completed by using the example also. It going to display, it going to tell wherever the cursor, that is from the 0th to the 20th byte. Now the second thing about our seek P offset and seek dir. So in this example, there is no any extra point. Here we can say that the seek P, here also two arguments are there in seek P. One is the offset, second one is the seek dir. So seek P offset and the seek dir. And the first one is the offset indicate the number of bytes the put pointer is to be moved from seek dir position. That means we know that the offset means maybe it going to move from the 0th byte, maybe it going to move 20th byte, maybe it going to move till the 30th byte. Till where it going to move, till where you want to display the information. And we know that the seek dir position contain the constant seek dir positions are, one is the beginning, second one is the current, third one is the end here. And also we know that the meaning of the beginning, current and the end. So first example in file seek B 0 IOS beginning. So move the put pointer to the 0th byte. Okay. Here that means it going to display the information that is from the beginning of the file. Beginning of the file. Here it going to display the information wherever the cursor is there. We will get it here. Okay. Here, so it going to display the put pointer going to display to the 0th byte, that is from the beginning of the file, for writing, for displaying purposes we using the seek P. Now the second example in file seek P 20 IOS current. So here we know that wherever the cursor is there in current position, wherever the cursor is there, it going to display till there. Okay, so first of all, move the put pointer to the 20th byte. That means maybe sometime the cursor going to blink from the beginning. That means it going to start from the beginning to the 20th, or maybe sometime the cursor going to blink in 4th position. So this is called as the current position. Maybe the cursor is blinking in 4th position. Now this is the current position. Maybe the cursor is going to blink in our 6th position. Now this is the current position wherever the cursor is there. So from current position to the 20th byte it going to display the information. So here we can say that is from current position of the file in forward direction. Okay, it going to move one after the another in forward direction here for displaying purposes. We using the CP. Now the third example, in file CP -20 IOS end. That means sure we know that till the end of the file we need to place the cursor. That means end of the file. Lastly we need to place the cursor here and it going to move in a backward direction. Clear this point here? So it going to display the information from the backward direction. So the above example tells that the put pointer points to the 20th byte in a file from the end of the file. That means we need to place the cursor at the end of the file and it going to move or displaying information from the backward direction in this case here. So this is about some example about our internal stream operation, that is the seekg, seekp, tellg and tellpeak here. And after completing the lastly about our tellg member function. So the meaning of the tellg member function. Now maybe I want to know our get pointer or the put pointer is there in which position. Just to know about all those information, we using some of the member function. The member function is the tellg and tellp. So firstly, I want to use the member function tellg. So the ifstream class provides member function. The name of the member function tellg. Okay. The purpose of the function is to return current position of the get pointer. That means the get pointer is there in which position, the current position of the get pointer. Just to know our get pointer is there in which position, we are using the member function. The member function is the tellg. So the syntax is the int position semicolon position is equal to fin dot tellg. Clear this point? If you are using this syntax, that means first of all we can't take any information. First of all, to take any information we know that we need to declare. So here just only I am declaring such position, that is by using our int, and we know that the position going to display maybe in first byte, second byte, third byte, fourth byte. So everything going to display in the number. So such position going to declare by using the data type int. Okay, so int position, and after using declaring the position, I am using position is equal to fin. And why I am using the fin? We know that the if stream, that means the tellg member function belong to the class if stream. So we are using fin dot tellg. So clear this point, what's the use of the tellg member function. And after the tellg, the next member function name call as the tellp member function. So we can't say why, because still here whatever the p value if we get, always we are using off stream, correct? No, kya? But here we can't say in this case here the tellp belong to the class off stream, but we can say that the tellp also belong to the class if stream only. Should remember it. Why? Because here we can say that the if stream class provides member function the name tellp. Okay, so the purpose of the tellp member function is to use to return the current position of the put pointer. That means our put pointer is that the displaying, we using the put pointer to display the information, correct? No, kya? So the return current position of the put pointer here. So the syntax is the int position. We know that before going to take, first of all we need to declare, and after the declaration we are going to take some of the declaration data type or the variable. So the position is equal to fin dot tellp, and we know the meaning of the tellp. The tellp is using or the purpose of the tellp member function to return current position of the put pointer. That means the put pointer is there in which position, or the current position of the put pointer. And the last point of this chapter is the basic operation on binary file in C++. Okay, the basic operation on binary file in C++. No any extra explanation about this one. That means such binary file, we know the meaning of the binary file, so are very much used. And when and specially going to deal with database operation, and in database we know that the collection of information, so it consisting of a collection of records, correct? No, yeah. And in database many type of the columns are there. Maybe for be in case you want to enter some information in a number, that means sure we are using the int. Maybe you want to add some of the character as a name, that means you are going to use the data type character. So here we can say that the usually the record consists the homogeneous data types. Clear this point here? It consists the different type of the data types. And when you are going to compare our text file and binary file, the input output operation would be faster, would be faster in our binary file when compared to the text file. Clear this point? Why? Because we know that the binary file that contains the information in the same format as it is held in memory, it not going to convert, it not going to translate the data here. So all those data will get in 1 and 0 format only here. There is no any translation occur here. So because of this reason, we can say that the file input output operation would be very fast when compared to our text files here. Yeah. And we know that in our binary file, some of the important member functions are the read and the write here. Yeah. Now after completing about read and write each and everything, now the basic operation on binary file in C++. So what are the operation we can perform by using our binary file? So some of the operation we can perform by using the binary file are searching. We can search any information, we can search any records. Okay, appending the data, that means if you want to add some more information into the file, into the binary file, you can add some data, that is called as the appending data. Third one, inserting data in sorted files here. That means we can say that if you want to insert some extra record, you can add some record into the file here, or maybe you can delete any record from the binary file, or maybe in case you want to make some of the modification, that is called as modifying data or the changes. If you want to make some of the changes in the file, you can do it by using our binary. So all those operation that is performed by our binary file. So some of the operations are, the operations are, first one is the searching, second one is the appending, adding some information, extra information, and inserting data into the binary file, deleting any record from the binary file, and making some of the changes, that is called as a modifying data in the file. And after knowing each and every information that is from the data file handling, so now this is the end of the chapter. Thank you.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.